Hello everyone, thank you for coming up today. My old subscribers, thank you. And to those that are viewing for the first time or that have not subscribed, please click on the subscribe button and the notification bell so you get notified each time we upload a new video. And to my new subscribers, thank you for subscribing. Please do not forget to hit on the like button. A particular country has been set into mourning after their president was assassinated. This is serious. President of Haiti, that's Jovenel Moïse, has been assassinated in his private residence by a group of armed men. Isn't this hard to believe? Coming to see that a sitting president assassinated in his own home. And the country's interim prime minister, that's Claudie Joseph, said that a group of unidentified individuals attacked the private residence of Moïse and shot him dead. First Lady, that's Martine Moïse, is hospitalized following the attack early Wednesday, July 7. That is today. This just happened today. And the wife was home with him. But fortunately, she is still alive. The Prime Minister said that the attack was carried out by an armed commando group that included foreign elements. And it happened around 1 o'clock in the morning during the night of Tuesday 6th to Wednesday 7th, July 2021. That's the group of guys, they are unidentified individuals, including some that were speaking Spanish, attacked the private residence of this president and fatally injured this man, shot him dead instantly. And as we speak now, all measures are being taken to guarantee the continuity of the state and to protect the nation. And the attack occurred amid a rising wave of politically linked violence in the Caribbean nation. The nation of more than 11 million people had grown increasingly unstable under the late president's rule, that President Moïse. Its economic, political and social woes have deepened with gang violence spiking heavily in the capital of Port-au-Prince. And they said that these troubles come as Haiti still tries to recover from the devastating 2010 earthquake and Hurricane Matthew that struck in 2016, which was a very tragic moment for them at that time. You know, that hurricane, it destroyed a lot of things, lives lost, property destroyed, and you know that Haiti is still struggling economically to stand on their feet. It stands as one of the most struggling countries. The 53-year-old late president had been ruling by decree for more than 2 years after the country failed to hold elections, which led to parliament being dissolved. Opposition leaders have accused the late president of seeking to increase his power, including approving a decree that limited the powers of a court that audits government contracts and another that created an intelligence agency that answers to only the president. So it was seen that the president was going in for another term and the people were not okay with it. And right now, Haiti claimed that Moïse, as the late president, should have stepped down on February to coincide with the fifth anniversary of the 2015 election that were cancelled and then rerun a year later because of the allegations of fraud. But the late President Moïse and his supporters rejected that argument, saying he only took power in 2017 after winning the rerun, and Haiti was scheduled to hold general elections later this year. So the obsession or the anger of the people of Haiti was that the late president was meant to have stepped down, but he continued in power, and that created a lot of stir of anger, rage in the community, in the country, by other people. It's so painful that he has lost his life like this. As of now, they've not identified anybody or group of persons that actually carried out this horrible act. To the people, they felt that their president should have stepped down long before this time of him being killed. But he didn't step down, and he was claiming that he only took into power 2017, while the people said he had taken into power since 2015 and was meant to have a rerun of the election again, but that did not hold. However anybody died is still very painful because they're taken away from their loved ones. It's such a pain that he has passed away, and currently his wife is in the hospital receiving treatment. May the soul of the late Haiti President Moïse rest in peace. May God console his entire family, and we pray for a quick recovery of his wife. No one would wish anybody's family to lose their loved one. No matter how people may not like somebody, but you know, coming to remember that this person may have his wife, kids that are out there and waiting for them, you would not want to wish them bad or wish them to go into mourning or pain. It's very painful. Even no matter how mean anybody would be, when you look at the kids and you look at the wife, you will be like, you feel sorry for them that their father and husband is no more there with them. We hope and pray that the wife would come out alive from the hospital and be with their kids. No one would wish children to stay without their parents, either the father or the mother, because the activities or the presence of both the father and the mother in a family is always very important, and no parents would wish their children to stay without them. It's such a pain. Well, however the country decides to go about it right now, either they would have a rerun of an election, or whoever was the vice may take into power for the meantime, pending when all of this is being resolved. Friends, what do you all think about this, the assassination of the president of Haiti and his wife being hospitalized? Please, if you have anything to say, you could put that down at the comment section. And the people were so filled with anger because they actually wanted the late president to step down peacefully. So could this be another way of saying, all right, the president, since he didn't want to step down, the people maybe decided to take the laws into their own hands to do it themselves? Well, investigations are ongoing at the moment, but from all indication, because they said that the people in the country didn't want him to continue, he wanted to keep on being in power. Well, looking at it critically, it says it all. But it's such a pain and a pity that he has lost his life like this. Friends, thank you for coming up today. Please don't forget to hit on the like button. Also, subscribe and hit the notification bell so you get notified each time we upload a new video. Thank you. God bless you all.